There was a time when courtesy and winning ways went out of style, when it was good to be bad, and when you cultivated decadence like a taste. We were all dangerous characters then. We wore torn up leather jackets, slouched around with toothpicks in our mouths, sniffed glue and ether, and when somebody claimed it was cocaine.
That's some good stuff! Yeah!
When we wheeled our parents' whining station wagons out into the street, we left a patch of rubber half a block long. We were 19. We were bad. We read Andre Guide and stuck elaborate poses to show that we didn't give a shit about anything. And at night, we went up to Greasy Lake. There was a single ravaged island 100 yards from shore, so stripped of vegetation it looked as if the Air Force had strafed it. We went up to the lake because everyone went there, because we wanted to snuff the rich scent of possibility on the breeze, drink beer, smoke pot, howl at the stars. The full-throated roar of rock and roll against the primeval chorus of frogs and crickets. This was nature. On one of our adventures, we came across a guy making out with his girlfriend, and we thought it was our friend Tony Lovett, so we decided to make fun of him.
Oh, you're
wrong.
What a nerd! Oh, you like girls?
What did you say about me, dude?
But we were mistaken. That wasn't Tony. He delivered a swift kick to the chin to Jeff, and Digby tried to take him down. I came at him and brought the tire iron down across his ear. The effect was instantaneous, astonishing. He was a stuntman and this was Hollywood. He was a big, grimacing, toothy balloon and I was a man with a straight pin. He collapsed, wet his pants, went loose in his boots.
You animals!
We bolted. First for the car and then, realizing we had no way of starting it, for the woods. I thought nothing. I thought escape. The headlights came at me like accusing fingers. I was gone. As I was about to take the plunge into the lake, I dropped my shoulder for the first slashing stroke. I blundered into something. Something unspeakable. A dead man.
Oh, dead man! Oh, uh-oh, no. What am I gonna do about this one?
I realized I forgot my keys, and it was too late.
They tried to attack me!
How dare you!
You motherfucker!
The townspeople started chasing me. Thick Midwestern accents. I couldn't escape. Toothless, sneakers gone, coated in mud and slime and worse, crouching breathless in the weeds waiting at my ass, thoroughly and definitely kicked and fresh from the hideous stinking embrace of a 3 days dead corpse, I suddenly felt a rush of joy and vindication. Here, I thought of the dead man. He was probably the only person on the planet worse off than I was. Who was he, I wonder, this victim of time and circumstance bobbing sorrowfully in the lake at my back? The owner of a shopper, no doubt. Bad older character came to this. Shot during a murky drug deal, drowned while drunkenly frolicking the lake. Another headline.
We got the gear scam!
Cap!
Digby and Jeff emerged from the trees behind me.
Oh my god, how's it hanging?
Are you okay?
Oh, I'm so fine, man. I'm just hanging by this tree. It's pretty safe.
It was pretty scary.
Oh, you know, it's okay. It's just another day in the life of Jeff. Oh.
After our reunion, the Spider Girl thought we looked pretty cool.
You were partying?
Maybe some other time.
I have a chiropractor's appointment.
Let's go.